वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज। इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन डबल सॉल्ट्स, सिंपल सॉल्ट्स एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन कंपाउंड्स। वी हैव आल्सो सीन पोस्टुलेट्स ऑफ वर्नर्स थ्योरी। नाउ इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल सी the examples based on postulates of Werner's theory, that is experimental verification of Werner's theory and its applications. Dear students, in Werner's postulates we have seen that there are two types of valencies for the complex compound. One is the primary valency and another is the secondary valency. Primary valency are non-ionizable and it corresponds to the oxidation state of the central metal atom. Secondary valency are non-ionizable and it corresponds to the coordination number of the complex compound. Then we have also seen that the primary valency is satisfied by the negative ions and secondary valencies are satisfied by negative ions as well as neutral molecules. Then we have also seen that secondary valencies are directional in nature, means secondary valency decides the geometry of the complexes. Now we will take one example of cobalt ammonium complex. In this, cobalt has a primary valency, that is oxidation state of 3, and exhibit secondary valency, which is the coordination number, that is 6. The secondary valencies are represented by thick lines and the primary valency is represented by broken lines that we have already discussed in Werner's postulates. Now if we have the complex having formula COCl3-6-ammonia complex. So dear student, in this compound coordination number of cobalt is 6 and all the 6 secondary valencies are satisfied by ammonia molecules. The black solid lines which is shown in the figure, the 3 primary valencies are satisfied by chloride ions, which is shown in dotted line. These are non-directional in character, means primary valencies are non-directional in character. These chloride ions are instantaneously precipitated on the addition of silver nitrate. The total number of ions in this case is 4, means when this complex is treated with or reacted with silver nitrate solution, then we will get 3 moles of precipitate of silver chloride. That means 3 chlorine atoms are ionizable in this particular complex. Means if we have drawn the structure of this complex, then we can see that three chlorine atoms are shown in the dotted lines. That means these three chlorine atoms forms the precipitate with the silver nitrate. Means in this complex we have three silver chloride precipitate, three moles of silver chloride precipitates, and the total number of ions in this case will be four. That is one for the complex and three for the chloride ions. So three chloride ions and one complex ion forms the four ions in this particular complex. The central ion and the neutral molecule or ions satisfying secondary valencies are written in a square bracket while writing the formula of the compound. Hence, the complex may be written as like this, that is, in square bracket you can write CO and 6 ammonia, and outside the square bracket there are 3 chlorine atoms. Means these 3 chlorine atoms are ionizable, and when treated with silver nitrate it gives 3 moles of AgCl precipitate, and that confirms that these 3 chlorine atoms are ionizable, and it corresponds to the oxidation state of the particular metal atom. We can see this in figure. This figure shows that there are 3 chlorine atoms which are shown by the dotted lines and which indicates the primary valencies of the particular complex. Then in this figure there are 6 ammonia molecules are having solid lines. Means these solid lines represents the coordination number of the particular complex. Means for this complex, that is COCl3-6-ammonia complex, the coordination number of the complex will be 6. That is, in square bracket we have 6 ligands, therefore its coordination number will be 6, and the oxidation state of the complex will be, or the oxidation state of the cobalt metal will be +3, because there are 3 primary valencies which are shown by the dotted lines. So from this we can say that there are 4 number of ions, one ion from the complex and 3 ions from the 3 chloride ions. So overall we have the 4 ions for this complex. Next example is COCl3-5-ammonia complex. In this compound the coordination number of cobalt is also 6. So dear student, remember that the secondary valency always remains fixed. So the coordination number of the cobalt complex is always 6, but the number of ammonia molecule is decreased to 5 from 6. In this case you can see that there are only 5 ammonia molecules, and in previous example we have 6 ammonia molecules, therefore its coordination number will be 6. But in the case of COCl3-5-ammonia complex we have only 5 ammonia molecules, so one remaining position is now occupied by the chloride ions. So this one position, remaining position occupied by the chloride ions. This chloride ion exhibits the dual behavior as it has primary as well as secondary valency. So in this case, what happened? One chlorine atom occupied the position of 6th ammonia, and it is also this, it also shows the primary valency as well. So in this case secondary valency is shown by full line and the primary valency is shown by dotted line in the figure. So from this figure we can see that there are 5 solid lines for 5 ammonia molecules, and one chlorine atom is having both the lines, that is solid as well as dotted lines. Means one chlorine atom satisfies both primary as well as secondary valencies. So in this case what happened? The structure will be like this, having two chlorine atoms having only dotted lines, one chlorine atom having dotted as well as solid lines. So in this case the coordination number will be again 6, and the primary valency, that is oxidation state, also will be +3. So this complex can be written as COCl NH3 5, and outside bracket we have only 2 chlorine atoms. So when this complex is treated with silver nitrate solution, then you will get only 2 moles of AgCl precipitate. That means the 2 chlorine atoms are outside the square bracket and 1 chlorine is enclosed in the coordination sphere. So everything which is in the square bracket is called as the coordination sphere. So coordination sphere encloses central metal atom as well as ligand. So there are 6 ligands, means the coordination number will be 6, and 2 chlorine atoms are outside the square bracket, means when it treated with the silver nitrate solution, you will get only 2 moles of silver chloride precipitate. Then number of ions for this complex will be 3, that is 2 for chloride ions and 1 for the complex ion. Then next, another example, that is COCl3-4 ammonia. In this case we have removed again one ammonia molecule. Then what happened in this case? In this compound, 2 chloride ions exhibit dual behavior of satisfying both primary and secondary valencies, because 2 positions are vacant now for ammonia, and then these 2 positions are occupied by the 2 chloride ions. Means this compound will give precipitate with silver nitrate corresponding to only 1 chloride ions. Now in this case we have only 1 chlorine atom outside the square bracket and 2 chlorine atoms are inside the square bracket to fulfill the coordination number, that is 6. So there are 4 ammonia molecules and 2 chlorine atoms inside the square bracket and 1 chlorine outside the square bracket, and those chlorine atoms are inside the square bracket satisfies both primary as well as secondary valency. Means these 2 chloride ions shows both solid as well as dotted lines, and they are indicated by both solid as well as dotted lines. So in this figure you can see that there are 4 ammonia molecules shown by the solid lines, 1 chlorine atom which is outside the square bracket shown by the dotted line, and 2 chlorine atoms which are inside the square bracket are shown by the dotted as well as solid line. So in this way you can draw the structure for COCl3-4 ammonia complex. Next is the example of COCl3-3 ammonia complex. In this case we have 3 ammonia molecules and 3 chlorines. So all the 3 chlorines chloride ions satisfy both primary as well as secondary valencies, and all the 3 chlorine chloride ions are inside the square bracket, or we can say that all the 3 chlorine atoms are inside the square bracket, which is also called as coordination sphere. So number of chloride will be precipitated on the addition of silver nitrate at room temperature. So no chloride will be precipitated on the addition of silver nitrate because there is no chloride ions outside the square bracket. So on treating with this complex with silver nitrate solution, you will get the reaction is not possible for this complex because you will not get any kind of silver chloride precipitate in this case. Therefore, the complex compound behave as neutral non-conducting molecule. So in this case, the number of ions will be zero, and therefore it does not shows any kind of ions. So it may be formulated as, so in this figure you can see that there are 3 chlorine atoms are shown by both the primary as well as secondary valencies, and 3 ammonia molecules are shown by the solid lines. This dotted lines is the mistake. Actually this dotted line is not in this particular example. Here is only for this ammonia molecules only solid line is there. So ignore this one. Only 3 chlorine atoms shows solid as well as dotted lines. So in this case we have 3 ammonia molecules, they are shown by the solid lines only, and 3 chlorine atoms are shown by both dotted as well as solid lines. That means the coordination number will be again 6 and primary valency is, that is 3. So now experimental verification of Werner's theory, we have actually discuss on this. So first example is the COCl3-6 ammonia, which is on heating with silver nitrate it gives 3 moles of AgCl precipitate. So this reaction confirms that 3 chloride ions are ionizable, and therefore primary valency is 3 and secondary valency satisfied by 6 ammonia molecule. Therefore this complex can be written as CONH3-6 and 3 chloride ions are outside the square bracket. In case of COCl3-5 ammonia, when heated with silver nitrate solution you will get 2 moles of AgCl, and it confirms that 2 chloride ions are ionizable and secondary valency is satisfied by 5 ammonia and 1 chloride ion. The complex can be written as CONH3-5ClCl2, and 1 chloride ion in square bracket satisfied both primary as well as secondary valency. We have already discussed this one. Then for COCl3-4 ammonia, when heated with silver nitrate it gives 1 mole of AgCl precipitate, which confirms that 1 chloride ion is ionizable and secondary valency is satisfied by 4 ammonia and 2 chloride ions. The complex can be written as CONH3 4 Cl2, and outside the square bracket there is 1 chloride ion. So 2 chloride ions in square bracket, which satisfies both primary as well as secondary valencies. And for COCl3 3 ammonia, on heating with silver nitrate, there is no change or no formation of AgCl precipitate. So this reaction confirms that all the three chlorine atoms satisfy both the primary as well as secondary valencies, and the complex can be written as CONH3 3 Cl3. So you can see that. So this is the experimental verification of Werner's theory. So in this particular example, we have taken the four examples. One is for COCl3 6 ammonia, second one for COCl3 5 ammonia, then COCl3 4 ammonia, and COCl3 3 ammonia. And this confirms that in different type of example, different types of primary valencies and secondary valencies are there, and this can be confirmed by taking the particular reaction with silver nitrate solution, and then by forming the precipitate we can confirm the number of chloride ions outside the square brackets. So this is all about the experimental verification of Werner's theory. Thank you.